We want to state the domain of the given function and then complete the table of values to graph. We have f of x equals the square root of the quantity x plus 2 minus 3. The domain is controlled by the expression underneath the square root, or this x plus 2, because if we take the square root of a negative number, it would not be real. So the domain would be all the values of x where x plus 2 is greater than or equal to 0. So if we solve this for x, we would have x is greater than or equal to negative 2, which would be our domain. Now, to complete a table of values for this, we want to select values of x so that the number underneath the square root of the radicand is a perfect square, meaning we want the radicand to be 0, 1, 4, 9, 16, and so on, because those are all perfect squares. So notice if we select x equals negative 2, we'd have the square root of 0, that's good. If we want this to be 1, x would have to be negative 1, since negative 1 plus 2 is 1. If we want this to be the square root of 4, x would have to be 2. If we want this to be the square root of 9, x would have to be 7. Let's find the corresponding y-coordinates for these x-coordinates. Again, if x is negative 2, y is going to be the square root of negative 2 plus 2, that's the square root of 0 minus 3, that's negative 3. If x is negative 1, y is going to be equal to the square root of negative 1 plus 2, or the square root of 1 minus 3, that's negative 2. If x is 2, we have the square root of 2 plus 2, or the square root of 4, that's 2 minus 3, that's negative 1. And if x is 7, this is going to be the square root of 9, which is 3. 3 minus 3 is 0. Let's go ahead and plot these four points and see what we have. Negative 2, negative 3, negative 1, negative 2, 2, negative 1, and 7, 0. So here's the graph of the given function. Notice how this does verify that our domain would be x is greater than or equal to negative 2. The function starts here at x equals negative 2,
and then moves to the right.
Because we're now familiar with the basic square root function and function transformations, hopefully we recognize that because of this x plus 2 underneath the square root, this represents a horizontal shift left 2 units, and the minus 3 here on the end represents a vertical shift down 3 units.
Which we can see here when we look at the basic square root function graphed here in red and our transformed function here in blue. So for any point x, y on the basic square root function, the point with an x coordinate of x minus 2 and a y coordinate of y minus 3 would be a point on the given function. Again, the blue function is shifted left 2 units and down 3 units from the basic square root function in red.
And we can also verify this using our graphing calculator. So if we press y equals, we can type in the given function, second x squared, x plus 2, close parenthesis, minus 3, and then we'll press graph. This gives us a nice visual of the graph, but we also want to verify our table of values. To do this, before we press table, let's check our table set. We press second window. Let's change this independent option to auto. So highlight auto and press enter. And now we'll press second graph. And now you can see why we selected specific values for x. Notice a lot of these function values would be difficult to plot. So if we scroll up to negative 2, notice how we have the point negative 2, negative 3, negative 1, negative 2, which is in our table, as well as 2, negative 1, and 7, 0. So our graph looks good. I hope you found this helpful.